Hello everyone, welcome to this video which we have decided to make based on a general tweet which I had posted last evening, and it got a huge response, and I can see that a lot of people related to that trader's position which I had mentioned. And the question was why this happens, what someone should do to not let it happen, and if it happens, what should be done next. So because of that, we decided, instead of just having my own talk, we decided to involve Krishna Kumar and Prashant Shah also. We also have Vittal Shinde, who also conducts the Paathshala. So he also has met hundreds of traders over the last few years. Between us, we might have met a few thousand traders over the last few years. So we really know the pulse of traders, what psychology they have. So just looking at that example, what I had tweeted yesterday, someone is short from 14,200, which he entered on budget day. First is why he entered that short. That is a separate topic. Looking at the replies which I received on Twitter, of course, I had, in the tweet I had mentioned, there were two catch phrases. One was repair and one was capital. I had talked about how that trade should be repaired, number one. I had also mentioned capital is not a problem. So these were the two points which threw people off track. Of course, it was not deliberate. It happened automatically. The point is, even if someone has huge capital, imagine Mukesh Ambani buys a new car and his driver bangs it somewhere, it crashes and goes completely. It can be repaired, of course, by spending 20, 30 lakhs or whatever. Will he do that? He has enough capital. Will he repair that car, or he will just scrap it and buy a new one? So here the main thing, capital is not a problem. Doesn't mean you need to firefight and defend the position. You just let that trade go. That was my view, which I had not mentioned yesterday. So capital is not a problem. You should take every trade as it comes. The other reply which I got was sell put, sell calls, make a strangle, buy ETF, and so many other suggestions which I got. Most of them were related to hedging by selling puts. The point here is, which I always talk about, hedging is not something which can be done by someone who doesn't know the business, which also includes options. First of all, hedging requires more money. Okay, in this case, money was not a problem. Capital was enough. But after the problem of money, you need to know what to do to prevent that loss. Let's say you short puts and suddenly market starts going down. Then even his puts will be in a loss. So is that the solution? I don't think so. My view of this whole saga is just get out. Of course, it is easier said than done. Get out when? That is a question, and how, because there your hand just does not go to the keyboard to exit. I understand every one of us have been in that situation, and first of all, when he took that trade, that time itself, it should be in his mind when he should exit, an exit level. So that is not something which people do, and hedging is something which is basically satisfying your ego after a trade has gone wrong. The best possible solution, as for me, is exiting the trade and then waiting for the next trade, even if it is long or maybe a short again, but let the chart tell you what is to be done next. First problem is, like, in fact, Shiva Galdani gave a very good reply to me on Twitter. He said, if you are going from Bombay, if you want to go from Bombay to Bangalore by train, and suddenly you realize halfway through that this train is going to Delhi, what will you do? You have to get out. So that is what is extremely important. First, if there is a fire in your house, get out, then see what. Firefighting is not something which a common man can do. You need experts for that. So this is from my side. Now over to you. You can speak one by one, and then we can have a discussion on this.
Yeah, shall I go, Prashant?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. So a couple of points you made, AP, which are interesting. Number one is you talked about the ego aspect. I think that is the biggest problem for a trader. So if someone has ego, then trend following becomes a big challenge. Right. Everyone, we have a certain element of ego, and we want that to be massaged. We are human beings, and that is unavoidable. But stock market or trading is not the place where you seek that ego massage component there. It's the wrong place to look for these things. So the other thing is your ego steps in when you have to honor your stop loss and exit the trade at a loss. Your ego will not let you do that. So I think these are the primary two problems which probably makes or forces the trader to get into this kind of scenario. I've been there, done that. I recall, I think in late 90s when IT stocks were just booming, I just got into trading and I read about RSI. RSI was 70 means overbought. And I just kept shorting IT stocks. And those days it was like weekly settlement. No margin requirements, nothing at all. If you knew your broker, you could go short 1,000 in fee or 100 TCS, no questions asked. So I used to religiously keep shorting those stocks. The primary reason being RSI was overbought. And it was 8% circuit then. So I could not cover my short positions because the stock was locked up at 8% circuit. I was short. The only option I had, I could average, go short more with the expectation that if prices fall, I will make a killing. But that never happened. And finally, my broker called me once to his office and told me that probably you are the only person who is not making money in this market. And that really hurt me big time. And one good thing was I didn't leverage and I just played with the capital I had and I blew up my capital. And that is like end of the story. So the point here is it was talking about my own experience. It was primarily my ego. I wanted to predict the market. I thought that something has run up so much. How much more can it go up? And I want to tame the markets, or rather, whatever you call it, like I can predict the tops or that kind of a feeling, isn't it? And it takes time for everyone to get out of that cycle and be more, what shall I say, adopt a different approach to trading. It takes a while. Everyone has to go through that cycle. But the point here is, if you don't have a system, then whatever you do is a mistake. That's what Van Thorp says. So if you don't follow a rule, it is a mistake. And if you don't have rules at all, then whatever you do is a mistake. So that is what I wanted, the point I wanted to make.
Yeah, well said. So I think this is about two things. One is following a stop loss, putting a stop loss in a system, or following a stop loss. And second is, or you can adjust the trade, you can, you know, hedge, or if you have money, you can just hold on. I mean, kabhi to that level will come. So that is a general perception. And one thing that, see, we used to conduct this trader's nest and all, or we still do it in Ahmedabad, Parchala and all this. So ek cheez to common hai, I think all of us will agree. And we have also been, we have also done those things. So ye jo, the incident that AP ne jiska baat kiya, in one or the other format, all of us have done that. So a common cheez jo hota hai, trader ka trade hota hai, ki people can hold in losses. I mean, loss kahan tak bhi will hold that position. But holding to the profit is very difficult thing. Riding the trend is, it's very easy to see that on the chart. You know, just if I just show this on the chart, for example, this ko main expand karu. Now, if I can just put the moving average here, I can see a good uptrend. It's very easy to see that on the chart. But now, just if I remove this and I just see that, let's remove the right part. I can see the top here. You know, I can give you a number of reasons why I can see top here. I can see top here also. There's a good hanging man kind of a pattern. Then I can see bearish engulfing here. There's also another top. There's also a resistance at the left. I can see top here as well. And then now today when I see the chart, I can see a clear uptrend. But if we go back, there was a lot of resistances that I could see on the chart. So idea of trend following is, the key aspect is, while we are following the trend, the key aspect is not to look at the resistance. Does not mean price will not reverse, but you should not do it. Then only you will be able to follow the strategy, because that's the core principle of the trend following strategy. That is one. When we come to mean reversion, it is okay. I mean, I see a reversal, I go short, but I should have a stop loss in the system. Every method has a stop loss. I think on Twitter or in books, everybody, all successful traders, I think they keep talking about the stop loss and risk management, right? But even after that, it is not very easy to follow. That is the core reason. I mean, it is very tough to put the stop loss in the system. I mean, we can say that the moment you open that drain, you put the stop loss in the system. But I don't see a lot of people can do that. So that is where the core reason is why this happens. That is one. I think second is, which is kind of question to you guys also. See, it is very easy to say that put a stop loss in the system. Acha, in a limited position size, it is okay. I mean, the retailers can do that. But beyond the point, it is very difficult. If you are doing it, your position size is significant enough. It's not easy to put a stop loss in the system and forget. You have to. So that's the practical
lost your
question.
Voice for sure.
No, I can hear.
And second practical thing is, what about people who are not following charts? How do they exit? How do they manage the risk?
No, one point from my side, what Prashant said was, it is quite fine to identify a stop loss level on the chart. The problem is, if my bias is so strong, bias can be anything. It can be someone's tweet I have read. It can be some message in a WhatsApp group. It can be hatred towards the... Oh, he's gone. Yeah. Now it's okay. Yeah, so basically the bias in his mind is so strong that he just does not respect the stop loss. So that is something which is easier said than done. If he's so strongly convinced that the market is going to go down because the budget is always bad, market always goes down after the budget, Modi kuch nahi karta, Donald Trump will tweet something, whatever, COVID. So these things which are at the back of the mind, that and the chart, that is the biggest war.
But the point is, AP, you have to draw a line somewhere, isn't it? At some point, you'll have to accept that the trade is not working and you'll have to just say enough is enough. Otherwise, what is the point? I think a couple of factors are important here. Number one is people always are very focused on the outcome of the trade that is currently open. They somehow want to ensure that this trade should not be a loser. They don't think about next 100 trades, 200 trades. They don't think in terms of large sample size. And number two is they always associate a losing trade with their personality and their IQ. I think psychologically that sort of comes into play, wherein if you have, say, 5 losing trades in a row, people somehow think that they probably feel a little bit depressed and they take it as a reflection of their personality, their IQ or whatever. So that probably forces people to either not respect the stop loss or remove the stop loss or not place the stop loss at all, whatever it is. I think these are the primary two factors. This is what I believe.
There is another point of thinking at it from the retail trader's mindset. if you take the same example which I tweeted, let's say he went short at 14,200 for whatever reasons. Then he realized the same day that the trade has gone wrong. It doesn't take any scientist to tell you that a trade has gone wrong. He knows even at 2 o'clock, 2:30, 3 o'clock, 3:15, 3:30 that the trade has gone wrong. What goes on in his mind is, okay, kal pullback aayega, I'll exit that time. And then it gaps up.
That pullback never happens. I gave you that 1990s example, right? But that pullback never happens. You exit the trade in absolute, disgust. And immediately, the moment you exit, the market will tease you. The price will momentarily move in the direction that you anticipated. And it will force you to go against the trend again. And the same cycle will rinse and repeat. So there is absolutely no solution to that at all. Trend following is much easier.
We have so many examples. Even Prashant has so many queries asked on TV shows. I remember, I think it was a couple of years back, KTK Bank. What was that example, Prashant?
So I think a client was, he was long at, I think that was the top 185 or some level. So he was heavily long in futures at that level, KTK Bank. And I think it was, when he called and he was asked, I think it was trading somewhere around 135 or something like that. I mean, see, at times people ask such queries to me or whoever. I mean, how can you handle? You have no way to, I mean, there is no answer to it.
Yeah.
He has bought something at 185. How can you answer it? It's just that people want to kind of know. I
mean, yeah, something which they are not going to follow.
Yeah. See, the point is when people ask these questions,
nobody can help you in those kind of situations. That kind of situation.
Yeah, fair enough.
No, in fact, it's a very funny thing when such questions are asked by these kind of people. We also start feeling sympathy for them. We'll tell him that support will pull back. And we try to think of it from his side. We don't say any, just cut the position immediately.
No, AP, that is a simple, straightforward solution, but the recipient will not like it. So he will look for the next person. He will ask the same question, the next person, until he gets the answer that next support is at this level, hold on to your position. That is the answer he is looking for, because he doesn't want to cut his position. There is no solution to that at all.
Another problem I would say for the analyst is, how can I say I don't know? TBQI.
Which is a fact, actually. We don't know.
Nobody knows.
See, I was running this Q&A section. So every week, invariably, 80% of the questions will be, I'm stuck in this talk at higher levels. What do I do now? I could have given a single one-line answer for all the questions clubbed together, saying that exit everything. But that will make me very unpopular. And see, the point is, there have been people like that, and there will be people like that. New people, they have to go through that cycle and learn from their mistakes.
So do you, one question to, when we answer these questions, do you also think that we ourselves are a victim of what those people feel? We feel that if we tell them to exit, and then if the stock goes up, we will be wrong.
Yes and no. If you have been in the market for a while, your mind will be conditioned to the extent that even if you sell something at say 100, you are okay to buy the same stock at maybe say 110 or 115 if conditions are right. But for a normal person who is relatively new to the market, he will find it very difficult to accept that.
People who don't understand charts, I have so many friends who don't know anything about charts. If I tell them ki buy SBI above 350, they'll say, above kyun niche bol do, niche le ko bol. That is the biggest.
So the only option, to an extent, what you say is right, AP, as in you want to protect your back and probably hedge your view. But if it is honest, straightforward advice, the only advice will be exit your loss-making positions and be done with it.
Yeah, what I meant was, when these questions are asked to us, even our ego comes into play.
Yeah, that does affect, that does influence, yes. At the back of the mind, ultimately, you and I, we are human beings and we have our image to be protected, isn't it? Within quotes, whatever little is left. You are only as good as your last recommendation. So that is the sad part. So you always want to hedge everything and manipulate that kind of a thing. You want to keep it open. But when you become a trader, these things don't matter at all.
Yeah. Perfect.
Basically, bottom line seems to be just exit. Choose a point and exit. That's the only solution, isn't it?
Yeah, so success in trading is about risk reward, right? It's not about hit ratio. Success of analysis is about hit ratio. Aap bolte ho kitna chalta hai. But in trading, how can you book your losses? I think that makes a difference. How can you exit your positions? I think that is the key thing. And I think holding to the position, coming to that question, another important reason would be your conviction on the view, which is because of whatever reason. I think for trading, conviction on method or process is more important. Mostly people have conviction on the view, which is, I think, very dangerous.
Yeah. So actually, after a long while, before the budget day, that weekend, someone called me and asked my view on the market. I didn't know how to answer that question. I told them that I've lightened up on my cash holdings and my short position in index got stopped out, and I don't have any positions. That is the only honest answer I could give. But the person who called me was consistently probing me, wanting me to give a view on the market. Then I said, on the face of it, things look bearish. But on Monday, once the budget speech was done, things just turned upside down and I went long in Nifty. But the point is, how do I connect to that person and tell them that I'm no longer bearish and I'm willing to look at the other side? That is a practical issue.
True, that is a practical issue. It is really very difficult to exit the position and book the loss, and that is why I think people keep on thinking about holding to it and adjusting the trades and all that. I think a very dangerous situation in your trading career could be, it's not about booking, it's just another trade. If you learn to think that way, it is just one trade, my stop loss got hit and I'm out. But I think overall the losses will come if your loss is very significant in one trade. That is the bullish, that situation should not come, and that is why a risk management or a stop loss is important. And I think people who are not following charts or something, at least they should have some kind of money stop. I mean, this is the maximum risk that I will take in one trade or one bag. That is what we should. And that's the mathematics about trading or investment, isn't it? I mean, how much risk I can accept.
But AP, you deal a lot with people who trade in options, isn't it? Do you think, what do you think makes people think in terms of doing those repair job? Is it triggered by not willing to take a losing trade? Is that the reason why people try to take some contra position to minimize the damage or the typical repairing thing that they talk about? What is it? Why is that mindset? Why is that happening at all?
If you ask me a blunt, if you want a blunt answer, the answer is ego. Nothing else. Mm-hmm. They just don't want to exit a bad trade. Because something which I don't realize, people don't realize is, if they start firefighting a bad trade by making adjustments and whatever, I mean, it's possible. I'm not saying it's not, it is possible. But your whole time, effort, money goes only into that.
Yeah. And
basically, you're just recovering your loss. You're not making any profit. Instead of that, if you book loss there, you are free in your mind. First of all, you get good sleep, biggest thing. Then you are free in your mind to go for another trade, which they just miss out completely on.
Yeah, I was just getting to that point, AP. Does it take a toll on your health, your mental and physical health, when you keep firefighting all along? What are the other aspects that is generally ignored?
See, there are two things. There are people who are extremely well-versed with managing positions. Fine. I mean, who have tremendous amount of experience. But the newcomers who have just read a couple of textbooks and maybe some blogs or some tweets, they will definitely fail in that hedging process. I understand there are experts who have been trading for a long time who are doing it well. Again, for me, it is still fighting their ego. I still don't agree with that. But they come out successfully. I know a lot of such cases where the trade went bad, but then they defended it and came out in plus. But then they didn't realize that they have lost so much time, effort and sleep in doing that. Not only health, it also something very serious. It also affects your family life. People don't realize that.
Yeah, that's a valid point. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a valid point. See, there can be option strategies, calculated option strategies. That's a separate thing. I mean, that could be that. I mean, you have your clear payoffs and everything. But I have done that. Just for example, you're trading some strategy in futures, and you are you have open positions, and you are nervous. You are worried about the next day, and for that you are hedging something by, you know, buying, for example, I'm long in Nifty, I'm buying put or I'm trying to write calls and all that. People should realize there is also cost to it. I mean, it's not that you are doing it. And at the end of it, if you see, you realize that it was all the unnecessary thing. So at least at times it is better to accept the risk and just stick to the strategy.
Yeah, fair point.
I think we have covered a lot. Vithal Shinde also here. Maybe we can hear something from his side. Maybe his own personal experience. Vithal?
Yeah, hello, sir. Thank you. I would just like to see my experience in the capital markets is very small compared to really you all mentors. And the pandemic fall was the first major event that I have really witnessed, and I was the real spectator of the real events that unfolded during the lockdown worldwide as it started. So I also had huge cash positions and F&O positions also. the only method that really I was taught by you all and I had really learned and practiced is putting a stop loss for the open positions. I would really like to add to this that I had almost 50 positions in cash when the pandemic started. So it becomes difficult to monitor the stop losses, but definitely putting the now as if we are a positional trader, we have the liberty of almost the entire evening and night after the market closes to understand where my stop loss will be. So even if it is maybe 2-4% here and there in cash positions, it is okay. But for F&O positions, we should definitely first look for the nearest exit. Because the moment we see that the position is not working, the leverage part will act against us. So where we are looking for the profits to multiple, here the losses are going to multiple. So definitely exiting at the first sign of problem or the first moment we realize that the trade is not working for us, definitely we have to exit. But even before that, before even taking the trade, one should understand what should be my level of exit if it goes against me. What is my trailing method? What is my profit booking method? What is my position sizing? So unless and until these questions are unanswered, one should really not trade. That is what I feel. And for those people at least who where the capital is not a constraint, they are really very fortunate people here, because I see a lot of people who really do good practice, but they are not really having the good backing of a capital that they really need. So if you are too fortunate that you have a good capital that will back you for your trading career, then at least don't ruin that advantage that you really have. So that is what I would like to add and request all the listeners that please have a process in system, have a process in place. Practice that process for some time without giving any importance to the outcome. Maybe your process will definitely have some good success immediately. So that can be a beginner's luck. Also, that at times you may have consecutive losses when you start the process to practice, but that is not that you should quit. So in either case, do some practice. Now when you are doing it as a practice, first do it with a small position sizing so that the losses won't affect the later growth of the career. So this is only I have followed and benefited in 2 years since I started trading. I was able to quit my job. I am today a full-time trader. Also, I am able to impart my experiences through the Paathshala. And this is only because I have been following the good lessons that I have learned. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Finally, I think it all boils down to discipline. And you should treat trading as a business where, I mean, if you open some shop somewhere, you will not just let it go in losses. So you should treat even trading as a business, and any losses have to be taken seriously. That is the bottom line.
Yeah, one more point, AP. We must, the person should own up for the losses and profits, right? We always try to take the credit if it is a profitable trade, and if it is a losing trade, we try to find excuses for why the loss happened. It could be stop loss funding, it could be something else, or whatever. We find 100 reasons, but if it is a winning trade, we always want to take the credit for that. So that is something that needs to be addressed. And the other thing which is very important is if the trader, especially the newcomer, if he makes himself accountable to somebody, especially the spouse or some close friend or colleague or whatever, that makes probably forcing some kind of a discipline that much more easier. You know that you will have to be accountable to someone else. So that will make you a little bit more responsible in what you do and follow your system, because you know that the other person is going to ask you, why did you not exit this trade when your stop loss got triggered? If you don't have an answer, you're going to be held accountable. But if you are very secretive and if you do everything yourself, right, then these kind of things aggravate. So the best thing is be accountable to your spouse. So that will be a very, very good moral check.
Yeah, so now for concluding remarks, I mean, everyone knows that you have to be a disciplined trader, treat it as a business, exit the bad position. That is what I can say from my side. Over to you.
Yeah, but I 100% agree, AP. And I strongly believe that everyone goes through that cycle. I just keep repeating it. There is no way that you are going to avoid a particular cycle. And the earlier you realize what the mistake that you are committing, the better it is for you. So, and these days you have access to experienced traders. It is so much easier to interact over Twitter and other social media. Make use of it and try to cut short your learning curve. That's it.
Yeah, I think trading is all about managing risk, I believe. And you should stick to one particular approach. That is very important. There are so many ways to trade the markets. You have to...
Yeah.
You know, stick to one. That is a key thing, I believe. And whenever you're, you know, as per your strategy, you have to exit, you have to do it. And that conviction cannot be borrowed, I believe. You have to work for it. You can learn methods, but you can't learn conviction. You have to work for it. I think, and that plays a key. So you have to exit position as per your plan. That is, I think, all about it.
Yeah.
I hope viewers will benefit, and finally it all boils down to discipline, getting out of a bad trade. That's the bottom line.
Yeah, nice session, AP. Okay, thanks for
calling. Let's end this session.
Yeah.
Thanks, AP. Okay, we enjoyed it.